And he's probably trying a different way. Maybe he figures, hey, maybe if I wear this man down first, I'll have a better chance.
Psychology is good. However, I've seen Morocco, Pat, absorb so much punishment match after match and still have the ability to come back.
Well, I'll tell you how smart Morocco is. When he plays possum, by the time you think you got him, that's when he makes the move on you and you're done.
All it takes is one mistake. Look at this. Morocco picked up that double leg and turned that side headlock into a backbreaker to his advantage. Morocco's shaking out, trying to get those cobwebs out from between his ears. Gets to his feet now, but not 100% balance-wise. Tito took a vicious backdrop there, a backbreaker. Manages to get both legs. Morocco reaching for the rope. Referee coming over to break it, but oh, he brought him back in the hard way. Dropped him on that lower back area and right back to that side headlock. Takes him over and arches right up into it. Quick two count by referee Dick Lutz. Crowd was screaming, and I don't think Morocco knew there was a two count going on. Boy, that could be dangerous in a jam-packed arena, Pat.
Oh, with the noise and the people screaming, if you don't pay attention to the count, you're in trouble.
Seen many a good wrestler get counted out just in that manner.
And you know, a lot of time when you're sweating, you get sweat going to your ears, and your ears get plugged up, especially with a headlock like this.
Two count again. Tito started with that side headlock right off the bat, and he's still got it. He's getting good results with it. No point letting it go now. He's worked on that area for quite a while. Why should he go to something else?
That's right. He's in control. He's successful this way. He's doing good. You know, when you work on a headlock like this for a long time, you will wear your man down. There is no question about it. Look at the neck, the pressure he's putting on the neck of Morocco. And Morocco now is really sweating right now. He's really having a hard time.
Captain Luis Albano still wandering around the ringside. Tito Santana still squeezing, still holding on. Look at the look on that face. Greatest walking advertisement for birth control I've ever seen in my entire life.
Couldn't have said it better.
Morocco now managed to get to his feet. He's underhooked with the leg from the inside. Might try to snap Tito back here. Trying to reach his left arm through to break this side headlock. If he does, he'll have the advantage and the momentum to drop Tito straight back on his back. He didn't get it. Tito kept ringing it out and forced him to break it.
Morocco is tired. Morocco is getting worn down.
Well, that side headlock ringer has wrung a lot of the steam out of him. Going for the cover, but not able to get it. Morocco, big, powerful individual. Shoots one of those shoulders through on that cover. It's tough to keep those shoulders down there.
Morocco is very agile also, I must add.
Oh, he can do it all, Pat. Drop kick, flying head scissors, whatever you want. He can do it.
Well, he is a champion surfer. And to be a champion surfer, you've got to have agility, balance.
Tito Santana in control with a side headlock. Morocco taking a great deal of punishment here. If he doesn't come out of this thing very shortly, Santana will have worn down enough to get a pinfall. You know he's not going to quit. He's not going to submit.
No.
Morocco definitely not a quitter. Santana just squeezing. His arms got to be tired now too, and his fingers and his wrist. Morocco to his feet now, trying to get up as high as he can to alleviate some of that downward pressure.
There again, Morocco to trying to get, he's got him this time. He's got him. Now Tito has done really hurt the back of his head. Now Morocco is going to try to clear his head.
Well, Morocco tried that inside leg hook for a back suplex earlier, couldn't get it, but he certainly got it in that time, snuck it in, dropped Tito right down on the back of his head. Oh, drops an elbow on him right above us. Magnificent one, trying to pull himself together as Tito Santana took a big elbow right to the lower neck area. And Morocco now in control. Still hurting himself, but has the upper hand at this moment. Oh, he jammed his neck back again once more into that top turnbuckle, trying to do some damage to the back of the head area, back of the neck area. Morocco now seems to have cleared some of those cobwebs. He's going to go to work on Santana. Two handful of hairs picks him up. Oh, power slammed him right in the center of the ring. This could be it. One, two, oh, two and a half, and Tito just kicked out.
Or he kicked out at the last second.
Beautiful power slam by the champion as he drove Tito Santana down into the mat cover. Morocco now waiting patiently. Oh, he raked the shoelaces right across the eye of Tito Santana. Morocco still shaking his head, but Santana's the one now that he's trying to clear the cobwebs because he's in trouble. But he's got determination, Pat.
Listen to the fans. Tito, Tito, Tito. That's what you call support.
He's going to need a lot more than support now. Big right hand didn't have all that much on it as Morocco just stepped one step backwards and came right back. Oh, the big right hand across the chin drives Morocco back a couple of steps. And another one. Both men hurting now. Santana with the upper hand with some big right hands as the champion reels and finally goes down. Plants a big boot right on the forehead. Captain Louis Albano is on the apron and in the ring, and he gets caught with a right hand. And another one. Santana drives their heads together. Captain Louis Albano has no business in the ring. Morocco now into the turnbuckle. Tito with a flying body press, and Morocco dropped down.
I don't understand this. Albano entered the ring.
Why? Automatic disqualification for offside interference.
I can't believe it.
Santana hit hard on that bottom rope as he missed that flying tackle. Morocco now going up the inside on the second turnbuckle. Will he go all the way to the top? Yes. No. Yes, he is up to the top, but Tito is on his feet. Morocco nails him with a right hand and another. Morocco sitting on top of the turnbuckle. Now front faces locked. Tito and both men go over the top rope. But referee Dick Lutz has already called for the bell. Didn't see a count or anything. Don't know what's happened here. Both men slugging it out on the arena floor.
Looks to me like Morocco does not want to take anymore. He doesn't want it anymore.
Oh, he banged his head right into the steel steps. Santana administering some heavy punishment. Now bangs his head down into the table and the belt. Santana gone bananas, won't stop for anything or anybody. Morocco in desperation grabs his belt. He must think he's the winner. Tito Santana back into the ring. Magnificent one all the way back to the dressing room. Now explaining the decision to Howard Finkel. Let's get it from Howard.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 16 minutes, 3 seconds, referee has disqualified both men and has declared this bout a double disqualification.